Hi, Ben.
Oh, hello, Kingfish.
Ben, I got some prices, collector's items here, that I got to part with and convert into cash.
Oh, your wife out of town again?
Oh, yeah. She went to Baltimore to visit her sister, and she done stripped the bank account before she left.
Well, let's see what you've got.
Well, Ben, I know as a rule, you don't buy no furs. But this is a choice item. Yeah, I just come off of the collar of the coronation gown of the Tsarina of Sweden. Beautiful piece, ain't it? Now, you know a Tsarina ain't gonna wear any kind of old cat round her neck. That's genuine wild mink.
Wild mink? Mm-hmm. Well, they must have had a rough time taming it. Sorry, Kingfish, not interested.
You ain't, huh? Ben, where's your wastebasket?
Now, what else have you got?
Now, this next item is really something. It's gonna make your eyes pop right out of your head. Look at there. There ain't but two of them in existence. The other one is in the Metropolitan Museum of Jewelry.
What is this, Kingfish? Is this a cultured pearl?
Cultured? Why, if that pearl could speak, it wouldn't speak to neither one of us. Yeah, look at there. Look at the fire in there. The beauty, the color, and the luster.
I'll give you a quarter for it.
Sold. Ben, I don't know what I'm gonna do from here on. I done exhausted all my huckable items. Ben, I desperate. You don't know how lucky you is to have this little place of business to support you.
But don't let it fool you, Kingfish. I'd sell the whole business right now for $1,000 down and finance the rest if I could get a buyer.
You would, huh?
That's right. And say, there's a chance for you to make some money, Kingfish. You sell this business for me, Kingfish, and I'll give you $250 commission.
$250? Holy smoke. Then I'd be back on Edie Street again. Ben, I'm gonna get right on the ball.
Now, don't forget, there's a lot of fine antiques in here.
But Kingfish, I'm happy with my taxi business. And besides, I ain't got no $1,000 to invest.
All right, Amos, but I tell you, missing out on a great thing. Now, let's see who else might be interested. Not Andy. Cause that boy ain't got no money laying around no place.
Well, Andy don't talk about it, but he has got some money and it's already invested.
He did?
Yeah, he bought some utility stock. I think it was in some gas company. But I know he wouldn't sell it. He's got it tucked away someplace.
Got it tucked away, huh? That's funny. I thought I had that boy completely untucked by now. So long, Amos. I'll see you later.
So long, Gingy.
Oh, hi, Kingfish.
Oh, hi, Andy. Have a seat, Andy, while I finish indigesting my daily Wall Street Journal here.
Oh, I never read that, because it ain't got no funnies in it. Hey, tell me, Kingfish, how's things down in Wall Street?
Well, they don't look so good, Andy. Yeah, Andy, you was lucky that you ain't got no stocks or nothing at this time.
Well, I didn't want to tell you, Kingfish, but I is got money invested in stocks.
Why, you don't tell me. Well, Andy, be thankful that you ain't got your money invested in no gas stocks.
Well, that's just what I got.
What? You got gas stocks? Well, Andy, you done invested your money in the one thing that ain't gonna have no use to nobody. Gas.
Now, wait a minute, Kingfish. What's wrong with gas? Everybody needs gas to cook with, don't they?
No more they don't, Andy. In the future, everybody gonna be cooking with atoms.
Atoms what?
Oh, no, Andy. Atomic energy. In the future, instead of gas stove, all the people gonna be cooking with atom stove. And, Andy, this atom stuff is so powerful that the stove only going to be 3 or 4 inches high.
Oh. If a stove is only 3 or 4 inches high, how is you going to put a turkey in it?
Good question you got there, son. But I'm going to explain it to you. In the future, instead of putting the turkey in the stove, they're going to put the stove in the turkey. Probably the reason why you don't grasp on to the thing is probably you don't understand how it works. Now, you see, Andy, first, the atom splits into what they call a monocle. And then the monocle busts and breaks down into what they call neutrons, protons, big newtons, and morons. Right. Then you got what you call radioactive turkey. You eat it, and it heat the house at the same time.
Yeah, I gotta admit, that's a lot better than gas, Doc. Oh. I really got nothing on this gas, Doc.
No, Andy, and as your friend, I want to tell you, if I was you, I wouldn't waste no time in getting rid of that stock. Then invest your money in, just for an example, the antique business.
Kingfish, this antique business you talking about, is this by any chance Ben's place that he's been trying to unload for 6 months?
So you knowed about it, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well, then why don't you open your big mouth and say so, instead of having me knocking my brains out with that proton and neutron stuff?
Sorry, Kingfish. I didn't know you was trying to stick me with Ben's place.
Say, Kingfish. Oh, hello, Andy.
Hi.
Look, Kingfish, I just drove a fellow over from the Lenox Arms Hotel, and he says he's your cousin Leo, and he want to see you.
Holy smokes, cousin Leo? You didn't tell him I was here, did you, Amos?
No, Kingfish. I didn't know whether you was in or not. He's waiting out in the cabin.
Well, I don't want to see him. Of all the mooches in the family, that boy is the number one mooch.
Oh, he is, huh?
Yeah, but I'm lucky that he's one of the relatives that I've never met face to face. But we used to get letters from him once a week asking for money.
He sure picked a fine time to show up.
Yeah, yeah, he is right in the middle of trying to find somebody with some money so I can get that $250 commission, and that chiseler got to bust in here on me.
Well, what you gonna do, Kingfish?
Andy, I gonna sneak out the back way. Let him in, Amos.
Okay, Kingfish.
Andy, tell him that Sapphire's in Baltimore and I just left for Europe.
So you're in Europe, huh?
Yeah, tell him I'm going to Paris, London, Liverpool, anywhere just to get him out of here.
Okay, Kingfish.
How do you do? I'm the Kingfish's cousin, Leo.
Hi, Leo. I'm Andy Brown. I'm sorry, Leo, but Sapphire's in Baltimore and the Kingfish is in Europe.
In Europe?
That's right. He's visiting all them big countries over there. London, Paris, Liverwurst. Oh, he's...
Dad, I came to town especially to visit him. But if neither he nor Sapphire's here, I guess there's no use in my hanging around. I might as well go on up to Buffalo and see Uncle Fred.
Yeah, that's the thing to do. Put the bite on Uncle Fred.
Well, it's not exactly for that reason. You see, I hit oil on some property in Oklahoma, and I've got some money to invest.
Well, it's like I say, Leo, you hit what, where, and you got what to do which with?
I said I struck some oil on my land, and I'd like to invest some money. I thought perhaps the Kingfish might know of something.
Leo, you just sit right down here and don't think about hurrying up to leave town. We might hear from the Kingfish sooner than we expect.
What are you talking about? I thought you said he'd sail for Europe.
Yeah, but, well, the chances are he might have went up the wrong gangplank and landed over in Staten Island.
That sounds silly.
I know it does. But don't do nothing till you hear from me, Leo. Now, you give me your phone number and where you living at. Hello? Leo? This is Brown. The Kingfish just called up from Paris, and he wanted to check up on things at the lodge, and I told him you was here.
Oh? Well, what did he have to say?
Well, he's flying back tonight on the Ile de France. Yeah, that's right. And he'd sure like to see you. He can meet you tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock.
Andy, I guess we're a little early. I've just been thinking.
What's that, Kingfish?
Now, if I sell Cousin Leo this business, I don't want him to think that he's dealing with any small-time operator. You got a buck, Andy?
Yeah.
Now, Andy, run down to the drugstore on the corner and get some of them long Panatella cigars. I'll flash them at him. Here's the money.
Thanks.
And don't forget to bring me my change, and I'll be waiting right here.
Oh, clerk.
Yes, Mr. Walters?
I'm expecting Mr. Stevens shortly. He was coming up to my room. But when he comes to the desk, would you please tell him that I'll be right here in the lobby?
Yes, sir.
Oh, excuse me. You gonna use this one?
Oh, no. Go right ahead. I'll finish with this one.
Thank you. Nice day, isn't it?
Yeah, it's always nice around New York this time of year. You from out of town?
Just got in. I came up to visit my cousin and her husband.
Yeah, I got a cousin here, too. Funny lot, ain't they?
Yes, in a way, I guess.
Now, you take this cousin of mine. All his life, he ain't been nothing but a chiseler and a loafer.
I guess some of them are that way.
Then all of a sudden, he come into some money, which just goes to show that the dumber you is, the better your chances are in this world.
Well, now, I wouldn't say that that's always the case.
Well, now, look at my cousin. He never had a dime up until the time he got this money. Always writing to us for a couple of bucks. My wife would have sent him 50 or 60 bucks this year if it wasn't for me.
You wouldn't let her, huh?
Well, I tell you what I done. When she'd give me the letter with the money on the inside, I'd always take the money out before I feel it. A smart fella, ain't
I? I don't think my cousin's like that.
Oh, don't you believe it. He's probably just a bigger heel as the rest of them.
Well, looks like my cousin's gonna be a little late.
I think I'll go in and get a cup of coffee. It was nice talking to you.
Oh, certainly was a pleasure.
Hey, yes, Kingfish.
Thank you, Andy. Well, Andy, now is the time to strike. Thank you, son.
Yes, sir?
Would you call Mr. Leo Walters' room and tell him that the gentleman he was expecting is here?
Now, let me see. Mr. Walters said he wanted to meet you here in the lobby. I saw him down here just a minute ago. As a matter of fact, I thought I saw him sitting over in that corner talking to another gentleman.
Well, where is he now?
He probably went into the coffee shop.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes?
Would you mind running through this thing just once again? I come up here and asked to see Mr. Leo Walters.
Right.
And you tell me that he was over in that corner talking to a man.
That's right. As a matter of fact, he was talking to you. Yes, it was you.
What's the matter, Kingfish? What happened?
Andy, talk about biting the hand that feeds you. I just gnawed Cousin Leo clean up to the elbow. Come on, let's get out of here.
Is you feeling all right now, Mr. Kingfish?
Yeah, Lightning, I coming around, but you better go out and get me another 100 aspirin, though.
Yes, I'll whiz right on out. Hi, Mr.
Andy.
Hi, Andy.
Well, Kingfish, I done what you told me. I called Leo and told him that your plane was delayed and that you'd see him later this afternoon.
Yeah, that's good.
You got the problem all worked out, Kingfish?
Well, Andy, I analyzed the thing on scientific basis. And I got a break on. Leo don't know what I look like.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, now here's how I done solved the problem. Number one, I can't say I the Kingfish because I done insulted the pants off of the boy. Mm-hmm. Number two, somebody else got to be the Kingfish. Number three, who gonna be the Kingfish? Number four, Calhoun.
Oh. You gonna let Leo think that Calhoun is you, and Calhoun is gonna try to sell Leo the antique shop, huh?
That's right. Now, all you got to do, Andy, is tell Leo that you heard from me and that I'd like to see him up to my place about 2 o'clock, and I'll take care of everything else. Calhoun! 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 Here comes Cousin Leo now. Now, Calhoun, is you sure you got everything straight?
Well, I think I is, Kingfish.
Now, this is what you got to remember, Calhoun. After a little friendly talking, chit-chatting, then you brings up the subject of what a wonderful investment that Ben's antique shop would be. And see, could you get him interested?
Look, Kingfish, I knows that. I knows all about that.
But now about this here chit-chatting. Suppose he asked me some questions about the family.
Well, Calhoun, I'll be right here in the closet, see? And then if he asks you some questions that you don't know the answer to, then I'll knock like this. Once. That means yes. Then I'll knock twice. Like that. That'll mean no.
Okay, okay. I got you now, Kingfish. One knock means yes, and two knocks means no.
Uh-oh. There you go, Calhoun.
Well, come in. Out of Kingfish. Glad to see you.
Well, Kingfish, at last we meet.
Oh, yeah. Always like my clothes nice and roomy. Rest your hat and sit down.
You know, Kingfish, this is very strange seeing you for the first time. Years ago, I seem to remember Sapphire's writing that you were nearly 6 feet tall.
6 feet, huh? Well, I used to be that tall, but I had a couple of ribs took out and I kind of settled down.
I still in Baltimore.
You want to know if Sapphire's still in Baltimore, huh? Yeah, she's still in Baltimore, all right. No doubt about it. Yeah, she's there. I just heard from her.
Well, is she going to be away very long?
No, she ain't going to be way long. She's going to be right back.
Going on, Kingfish?
It's probably one of the neighbors hanging up pictures or something. And you know, Leo, I wish whoever it is knocking wouldn't knock unless they had a reason.
Oh, I see. You know, it's funny, Kingfish. You know, outside of it being a little noisy, you have a nice apartment here.
Oh, yeah, it's a lovely apartment. It's comfortable, and we've been here quite a number of years, and we're just crazy about the place.
Well, how many rooms do you have?
You want to know how many rooms we have? We got 4 rooms. And a bath. And 2 sinks.
Well, I must say, it's quite cold.
Yeah.
Dave, I wonder what's going on in the Stevens' living room.
Oh, he's probably hanging pictures.
Say, that reminds me. You've been going to hang pictures for 3 weeks. And now's as good a time as any.
Okay, Mabel.
Leo, will you excuse me a minute while I go in here and put on something more comfortable? Kingfish, you stop that. Give me the answers before I give you the question.
That wasn't me. Really? There must be an echo or something in here.
Well, you tell the echo to shut up. I'm going crazy out there. Wait a minute. Is you got anything else in here I can put on?
Yeah, I reckon I is here, Calhoun.
You know, Kingfish, I was just thinking here. The worst part of my living as far away as I do from you folks is that you lose complete touch with the family.
Yeah, yeah, I know what you mean. Well, we misses you too, Leo.
Say, another one I've missed seeing for a long time is Cousin Susie. I understand that she got married a couple of years ago.
Susie? Oh, yeah, yeah, she got married. She married a wonderful fella.
Well, tell me, how many children has she got?
Well, now, let me think here. Quite a gal, that Susie. Well, as near as I can figure it out, it's somewhere between 15 and 20. And 2 more on the way.
Oh, it sure is wonderful being. There's so much I want to know about all my relatives. For instance, how long has Uncle Frank been married? How old is Cousin Charlie's little boy? Is Aunt Tilly still living with Joe?
Wait a minute. Let's take these things one at a time, yeah. Now, about Uncle Harry's little boy, he's just about to... alone in this apartment.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Just about to give me a headache.
Oh. They must have heard me. Because everything done quieted down. But now, Leo, to get away from the family talk, my friend Brown tells me that you up here looking around for a little business to go into.
That's right, Kingfish. You see, I have a pretty steady income from some oil wells now, and I'd like to find some little business to occupy my time.
Well, I tell you, Leo, not that it means nothing to me, but it just so happened that I knows of a little place of business right over here on Lenox Avenue that's for sale. It's an antique shop.
Antique shop, huh? Yeah. Well, that's a nice, clean business.
Yeah, and just the kind of thing for a fella like you that don't want to work too hard and still got a nice income.
You know, the more I think of it, the better a thing like that sounds.
Yeah, well, here's the address right here. I had the address a minute ago. I'm on the... Where is the address? The address... Here's the address right here. I think the place is still open. You can get right down there. A fella by the name of Ben owns the place.
Well, I'll tell you, Kingfish, I didn't get much sleep last night, and I'd kind of like to go back to the hotel early. Or maybe I can see this fella first thing in the morning.
Yeah, you do that. You can get the place for $1,000 cash and finance the rest of it.
Yeah?
Yep.
Sounds interesting, all right.
Yeah.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow, Kingfish, after I stop in at the place.
Yeah.
Sounds very interesting. Well, I'll be running along. Goodbye, Kingfish.
Yeah, goodbye, Cousin Leo.
Say, is this kind of hat the new style in town now? I saw another fellow wearing one of these.
Oh, yeah, that's a new style. Yeah,
this is your hat.
Oh, yeah. Like I told you, I like my thing nice and loose.
Well, goodbye, Kim.
Yeah, goodbye, Cousin Leo. Okay, Kingfish.
Congratulations, Calhoun. You was great. Everything worked like a charm.
Yeah, he going over there the first thing in the morning. And if you like it, I guess you got yourself a deal.
Calhoun, you are now looking at a man who does things in a big way.
Yeah, you and your cousin Susan. But you know, Kingfish, it'd be a shame if Leo go over to the antique shop and don't like the looks of the place.
Calhoun, I'm going to take care of that angle, too. Yeah. I'm going to have 8 or 10 of the brothers go over there tomorrow morning, just about the time that Leo going to get there, and everything will look like it's busy, and he'll think it's great.
Kingfish, you is a genius.
Him. I'll get in the closet.
Yeah. Well, good morning, Cousin Leo. Come on in.
How are you, Kingfish? How are you today?
Oh, just fine, Captain. Rest your hat and sit down. Cousin Leo, tell me this. Was you over to the antique shop?
I was. I just come from there.
Well, how did it look to you?
It was everything you said, Kingfish, and more. I never saw a little place as busy as that.
Well, tell me this. Did you go inside and talk to the man about buying the place?
I sure did. I went in and got my checkbook right out.
Oh, great. Great, Leo. That's great. Well, I suppose you worked out a deal.
Well, that's just what I came up to see you about. Ben said that business had picked up suddenly so much today that he decided not to sell.
One of them pictures that was hanging fell down.